Hi friends, today we will make flash drive which will kill any computer for a fraction of a second without the possibility of recovery. This is called USB flash drive killer, the data killer and USB killer and so on. Why such a device? Personally, I don't need it. I just wanted to show and tell about the principle of work and how to collect it literally from the trash. The principle of operation is very simple. In the box of an ordinary flash drive, a boosting voltage converter is assembled. It is powered directly from the USB as soon as such a flash drive is inserted into the USB port. If 5 volt came to the converter, then the high voltage formed and through data pins comes on the computer motherboard and burning all the controllers on its way. As a result, the computer is immediately destroyed. No possible turn on again. In general, such a device is inserted into the computer only to the most sworn enemy. By the way, such a flash drive can burn not only a computer, but also any digital equipment which supports USB. As said before, the power of the USB killer is taken directly from the computer's port, and therefore, if the computer is turned off, the killer is powerless. My version of the killer's device works differently. It can destroy even the shutdown computer. The circuit consists of a small lithium-ion battery as a power source, a charge controller for the battery, and a step-up converter. The basis of the converter was an electric lighter for gas. We need a transformer from it. By the way, let's explain how this lighter works. In fact, it is a high voltage generator that is powered by two AA batteries. Here is the gas lighter circuit. It consists of three parts: an initial boost converter, an energy accumulator with a contactor, and a high voltage coil. The power from the batteries rises to 50 volts, rectified by a half-wave rectifier, and accumulates in a film capacitor. The capacitor is charged through the primary winding of the high-voltage coil. The divider on the gate sets the thyristor tripping voltage. When the thyristor is triggered, the entire capacity of the capacitor is discharged to the primary coil winding. The resulting pulse contributes to the generation of a high voltage on the secondary winding of the coil. Voltage on the winding can reach 10,000 volts, although the current is very small for a person, such a toy isn't dangerous. Now let's go to our flash drive. From this circuit, I took a transformer, a diode, and a base resistor for a transistor. Everything else can be thrown out. Our circuit hasn't a high voltage coil and a contactor. The main destroyer is the energy stored in the capacitor. When pressing the button, computer will receive about 400 volts through the date pins. I assure, the computer has no chance. Few words about the components. The transistor was replaced by the BD140. It's more powerful than the one on the gas lighter board. The storage capacitor was replaced by a different one, with a voltage of 400 volts, a capacitance of 0.1 microfarad, shunted by a resistor of 1 mega ohm. The resistor discharges the capacitor after disconnecting the flash drive and also serves as a protection. Here we can see that the capacitor in a fraction of a second is charged to a voltage of 900 volts. With the resistor, the maximum voltage will be around 400 volts. The battery is lithium-ion with a capacity of 150 milliamperes an hour, has a built-in protection board against short circuit and deep discharge. Next, we need to find a suitable case from the USB flash drive and set all inside. In my version, this is the box from the card reader. The finished converter looks like this, and this is the view with the battery. Now about the battery charge circuit. The standard chip TP4056 was used, only it was necessary to unsolder it from the board and collect all another way so as to save space. By the way, in the charging circuit there is a resistor responsible for the charge current. I replaced it by 20 kiloohm, thereby reducing the charge current to 70 milliamperes. A pair of LEDs, one lit during the charge, the second when the battery is fully charged. The charge system will need to be checked before installation. If everything works normally, then the flash drive is almost ready. A charge is from any 5-volt charger. Just be careful and don't press the killer's activation button during charging, or you can burn out the charger or the device from which the flash drive is charging. And now I will show you the USB killer ability. We'll be right back. friends. If you like the video, please vote with thumbs up and share the video with your friends. Leave your feedback and in the future I will collect for you a lighter version of the same flash drive. A full archive with the circuits will be found in the description. Also, there are links to the purchase of flash drive killers. Now I have to say goodbye. With you was Kasian TV.